Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to explain the variation of the current in a series RC circuit fed by a square wave voltage. Determine the values of the current in the beginning and at the end of the charging process. And determine the values of the current in the beginning and at the end of the discharging process.
In this experiment, we want to study the variation of the current in a series RC circuit fed by square wave voltage. So here we have a resistor of resistance 1 kilo ohm connected in series with a capacitor of capacitance 100 nanofarads. The resistor and the capacitor are connected in series with a function generator. Observe the function generator is adjusted to provide square wave voltage. Now we want to display the voltage across the function generator and across the resistor on the screen of the oscilloscope. So I will connect the channel 1 across the resistor and channel 2 across the function generator. Now the ground terminal of the oscilloscope is electrically common with its metal chassis, so we don't need to connect the ground of channel 2. Now observe the curves on the screen of the oscilloscope. I will displace the curve of the voltage across the resistor to the bottom of the screen. Okay, now during a first half period, the voltage provided by the function generator is maximum. This is the charging phase of the capacitor. During this time, the voltage across the resistor decreases to zero. But we want to study the variation of the current. The voltage across the resistor is equal to the resistance of the resistor multiplied by the current it carries. For an ideal resistor, the resistance is a positive constant, so the curve of I is similar to the curve of the voltage across the resistor, differing only by a constant multiplying factor. So, here, when we say the voltage across the resistor decreases during the charging phase, then the current decreases to zero during the charging phase. When the current becomes zero at the end of the charging phase, we say that steady state is attained. Now, during a second half period, the voltage provided by the function generator is zero. During this time, this is the discharging phase of the capacitor. During this time, the absolute value of the current decreases to zero. And when the current becomes zero, again, we say that steady state is attained. Now, another important remark. Look at the curves of UR in the charging and the discharging phases. They have opposite signs, which means that the charge current and the discharge current have opposite signs. We conclude that the direction of the charge current is opposite to the direction of the discharge current.
Now, let's generalize the observed data in the previous experiment. The circuit includes a capacitor of capacitance C, a resistor of resistance R, connected in series across a generator G, providing a square wave voltage. UG, which is equal to UAB, is equal to E during the first half period, and is equal to zero during the second half period. The ground of the oscilloscope is connected to point B, and since the phase of channel 1 is connected to point M, so channel 1 displays the voltage UMB, which is equal to UR. And since the phase of channel 2 is connected to point A, then channel 2 displays the voltage UAB, which is equal to UG. But the aim of the experiment is to study the variation of the current during charging and discharging, and the oscilloscope does not display current. It displays only voltage. But we have UR is equal to IR, and R is a positive constant. So the curve of UR is similar to that of the current I, differing only by a constant multiplying factor. This figure shows UG and UR on the screen of the oscilloscope, while the right figure is a diagram that shows UG and UR as functions of time during one period T of UG. Let's study the curves between 0 and T over 2, or during the charging of the capacitor. UG remains maximum and equal to E, whereas UR starts maximum and equal to E, and then it decreases gradually until it becomes 0 at an instance T1. At this instant, we say that the capacitor is totally charged and the steady state is attained. And then between T1 and T over 2, UR remains 0. So we can conclude that during charging, the current starts maximum and decreases gradually to 0. And then the current remains 0 during the steady state. Now, let's study the curves between T over 2 and T, or during the discharging of the capacitor. UG remains equal to 0, whereas the value of UR just after T over 2 is equal to minus E, and then UR increases gradually until it becomes 0 at an instance T2. At this instant, the capacitor is totally discharged and the steady state is attained. And then between T2 and T, UR remains 0. So we can conclude that during discharging, the current starts with a value which is equal to minus I maximum, and then it increases gradually until it becomes 0. Or the absolute value of the current starts maximum and decreases to 0. And then during the steady state, the current remains 0. We observe that during charging, UR is greater than 0. And during discharging, UR is less than 0. That means during charging, the current is positive, and during discharging, the current is negative. So we can conclude that the charge and the discharge currents have opposite directions. And these currents are called transient currents.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's determine the expression of the current in the charging phase of the capacitor. In the charging phase of the capacitor, the voltage provided by the function generator is UAB, which is equal to UG, is equal to E. G, or the generator, acts as a battery during the charging phase. Now, before we start, we will take UAM as UC. Now, let's apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. So we have UAB is equal to UAM plus UMB. UAB is equal to E, UAM is taken as UC, and UMB is taken as UR, as we have seen in a previous slide. Now, UMB is equal to plus RI, because the positive sense is from M to B through the resistor of resistance R. So this is going to be E is equal to UC plus IR. Rearrange. I is equal to E minus UC over R. E is constant, R is constant, UC is variable. This means that the charge current is variable.
By referring to the expression of the current determined in the previous slide, let's determine the values of the current in the beginning and at the end of the charging process. At time zero, the capacitor is uncharged. That means UC is equal to zero. So replace UC by zero in the expression of the current. So at the beginning of the charging process, the current starts maximum and is equal to E over R. UR is equal to RI. At T equals zero, the current can be replaced by E over R. So at T equals zero, UR is equal to E over R times R, which is equal to E. So at the beginning of the charging process, the voltage across the resistor starts maximum and is equal to E. As time goes on, the capacitor charges, so UC increases. By referring to the expression of the current, I equal constant minus UC over constant, that means as UC increases, the current decreases. Finally, when electric equilibrium is attained, the capacitor becomes fully charged, or UC is maximum, and this maximum is equal to E. Replace UC by E in the expression of the current, so I becomes E minus E over R. We conclude that at the end of the charging process, the current becomes zero. Also, since UR is equal to RI, at the end of the charging process, the voltage across R becomes zero.
Let's determine the expression of the discharge current. In the discharging phase of the capacitor, the voltage provided by the function generator is zero. The function generator G acts as a connecting wire. Let's apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. UAB is equal to UAM plus UMB. UAB is equal to zero. UAM is taken as UC and UMB is equal to plus RI. Rearrange. I is equal to minus UC over R. R is constant. UC is variable in the discharging phase. This means that the discharge current is variable.
By referring to the expression of the current determined in the previous slide, let's determine the values of the current in the beginning and at the end of the discharging process. At the instant the capacitor begins to discharge, at this instant the capacitor is fully charged, so UC is equal to E. Replace UC by E in the expression of the current, we get at this instant the value of the current is equal to minus I maximum or minus E over R. So at the beginning of the discharging process, the current starts by a value which is equal to minus E over R. But UR is equal to I times R. At the instant of the discharging process, the current can be replaced by minus E over R. So at the beginning of the discharging process, the voltage across the resistor is equal to minus E. As time goes on, the capacitor discharges, so UC decreases. By referring to the expression of the current, as UC decreases, the value of the current increases, or the absolute value of the current decreases. And finally, when the capacitor becomes completely discharged, at this instant, UC becomes zero. And by referring to the expression of the current, we can conclude that at the end of the discharging process, the current becomes zero, and the voltage across the resistor also becomes zero. Observe the figure. During charging, UR is positive, and during discharging, UR is negative. That means during charging, the current is positive, and during discharging, the current is negative. So we can conclude that the charge and the discharge current have opposite signs. Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.